So, with this data,
why he say like that?
Here, Jesus said, you see, John, no.
What do you mean by this?
No, Jesus said, Philip said, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus answered, don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. What do you understand by that? When Jesus said, he that has seen me has seen the Father, what do you understand?
What do you understand?
That is the Father.
He is God by himself.
That means that he is the Father. Does that verse mean that Jesus is the Father?
Father sent him.
No, you don't listen to me. You said that Jesus is God.
Yes.
And then he said that when Jesus was asked,
are God is very life or not? He is familiar God. Where's the Father? Where's the Son? Where's the Holy Spirit? One God.
No, but listen to me.
Are you Muslim?
Listen to me.
Are you Muslim?
Let's finish that first. Okay. Yeah, I'm Muslim.
Okay. Because God is like me or like you.
No, Jesus.
He regret. Listen. He regret. He sent Muhammad to correct his mistake.
Okay, Jesus.
One is he make it everything.
You know you got a mistake here. You know you have a mistake
here.
John 1.
No. I don't believe it.
You know why?
If I follow Muhammad,
Jesus said you had a God. Jesus said you had a God.
I become a Muslim now. No.
God,
at this time.
Did Jesus have a God?
Who gonna save me?
I said, did Jesus have a God? Did Jesus have a God?
His Father.
No, he had a God.
His Father.
That is God.
Yes.
And he wasn't the Father. And Jesus is God. Jesus wasn't the Father.
And you believe
he is? No, who was he? Who was he worshiping?
I told you.
Jesus is God and he was his God.
God is familiar God. God the Father, God the Holy
Family.
The Son, God the
Holy Ghost.
One God.
Show me that. Yeah. Show me.
Genesis.
Show me here. Your Bible is here. No, I said show me here. Your Bible is there. No. God the Father. He said, God the Father. God the Son. And the Holy Ghost said, listen to me.
God made mistake.
You know why? I don't. You are reading from the creed. You don't know the creed. The Athanasian creed. The only verse closer to the Trinity is the first epistle of John 5:7. For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. That's the only verse in the Bible which is closer to Trinity. But Trinity is not here. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy, it's not here, show me.
Everything is created by God.
I said it's not there, you don't study your Bible. Jesus said he was sent by God. You know that Jesus said he was from God?
Yes.
If you read your Bible, in the Gospel of John, chapter number 8, John 8:42, Jesus said, if God were your Father, you love me, for I have come here from God. I have not come on my own. God sent me.
Because you understand? He is in flesh.
No.
Like man.
He said God sent me.
100% man, 100% God.
But God said he's not a man. God said he's not a man. Do you know that? You are lying. God said.
No.
Hosea. No, don't go. Don't go. You have read your Bible. Hosea 11:9. No. Hosea. Let me read it. You have read your Bible. I know.
Because God is.
You have read it. No.
Islam.
No. God said.
Islam.
I said God sent for the man. No. God sent in your Bible. God sent for the man. Never. You
didn't.
Okay.
God never make.
Remember. Okay. Here. Wait. Don't go. Here. Hosea. Okay. Here.
Hosea.
Hosea 11:9. Hosea 11:9.
It's for argument you collect it.
No, I think it's Hosea 11:9 here.
You want it to be with your life.
Yeah.
Live your life.
Yeah, you see?
I don't care.
So I am God, I'm not man.
I'm with you.
See, it's right. Run away, the man came here, he loved Jesus. God says not a man, you said it's not there.
What argument idea?
No, you said it's the Bible.
Argument you read
it's not, no, it's not there. Not there, yes, that's the thing. You see these people, he came to me, that's the thing. He's gone. They haven't studied their Bible. They believe that Jesus is God. I didn't tell him. He was talking about Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. I said in the Bible. I didn't tell him. The only verse closest to the Trinity is in the first epistle of John, verse 7. For the three that I record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. This is the only verse which is closer to Trinity. But the word Trinity is not the Bible. These people are following the Athanasian Creed. They are following the creed that they understand. I want to tell you, these my brothers and sisters, this is the creed that Christians all over the world follow. When you hear God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Almighty is God, Father is God, the Son is God, the Holy God is God. The Father is eternal, the Father is eternal, the Son is eternal, and the Holy Ghost is eternal. Co-equal, they are co-equal. You hear this in the Athanasian Creed. This is the creed. These are the words of the Athanasian Creed, as quoted from McClintock and Strong's Biblical Encyclopedia, formulated in the 4th century AD. The creed was a result of the controversy which raged from the 2nd to the 4th century. This is what it says. It says, the Athanasian Creed, we worship one God in Trinity, and Trinity in unity, neither confounding the persons, nor dividing the substance. For there is one person of the Father, another of the Son, and another of the Holy Ghost. But the Godhead of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost is one, the glory equal, the majesty co-eternal. Such as the Father is, such is the Son, and such is the Holy Ghost. The Father is eternal, the Son is eternal, and the Holy Ghost is eternal. So likewise, the Father is almighty, the Son is almighty, and the Holy Ghost almighty. So the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Ghost is God. The Father is made of none, neither created nor begotten. The Son is of the Father alone, neither made nor created but begotten. The Holy Ghost is of the Father and of the Son, neither made nor created nor begotten, but proceeding. And in this Trinity, none is afore or after another. None is before, none is greater or lesser than other, but the all three persons are co-eternal together and co-equal. So that as is aforementioned, the unity in Trinity and the Trinity in unity is to be worshipped. He therefore that will be saved must thus think of the Trinity. This is what he gets. The Athanasian Creed, this is the creed that the Christians all over the world they're following. But if you read the Bible, where do you get these concepts from? The key words in this Athanasian Creed, that Jesus, the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Ghost is God. It's not here. The Father is almighty, the Son is almighty, the Holy Ghost almighty. Not here. Co-equal, co-eternal, not in the Bible. But they're getting it from the creed, my brothers and sisters. The Bible is replete with verses where God, in the Old Testament, speaks about his oneness and his uniqueness. The Christians, when you go to church, the pastors will never quote these verses. I'm going to quote at least a dozen, my brothers and sisters. We Muslims are trying to reason with you that Jesus Christ, peace with him, was all a man, the Messiah sent to the kingdom of Israel. He never said he's God, he never said worship me. You are following the teachings of the church. The Trinity was a concoction, a fabrication, which was concocted by the Romans. Now let's go to the Old Testament and see what God says about himself and compare these verses against this concept of Trinity, this alleged divinity of Jesus Christ before him. If you read the Bible in the Old Testament, in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 43, verse number 10 to 11, just said, God said here in your Bible, before me no God was formed, nor shall there be any after me. I am the Lord, besides me there is no Savior. God says in Isaiah 43, 10 to 11, that besides him there is no Savior. But now you say Jesus is a Savior. Furthermore, in the Bible, in the Old Testament, as I said, Christian pastors will never quote these verses. When I come here, build the building, the rest, they don't quote these verses. Furthermore, in the Bible, in the book of Isaiah, chapter 46, verse number 9, God said, remember the former things of old, for I am God and there is no other. I am God and there is none like me. God said that there is none like him. My brother and sister, there is none like him. But he said, you believe Jesus is God and Jesus is a man. Furthermore, in the Bible, it is mentioned in the book of Exodus, chapter number 9, verse number 14. God is talking, he said, and there is none like me on all the earth, that you may know that there is none like me in all the earth. Here, God in the Old Testament speaks about his oneness and his uniqueness. Furthermore, in the Bible, it is mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 45, verse number 21 to 22. To run said, and there is no other God besides me, a righteous God and a Savior, there is none besides me. 22 said, turn to me and be saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God and there is no other. God said, turn to him to be saved. Well, you are turning to Jesus. So you are going against what God said in Old Testament. Are you telling me now that God changed his mind? Are you telling us that God, from the beginning, says that he was one, and he revealed that to all the prophets that he was only one Lord, and then later on he changed his mind to say that he is a combination of God, a triune God. Furthermore, in the Bible, it is mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 32, verse number 39, says that, see now that, and God is talking, see now that I, even I am he, and there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hands. God said there was no God with him. But in John 1:1, you believe in that. You quote it. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. John 1:1 and John 1:14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John 1:14 said, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. According to you, this is Jesus Christ is on him. But God, in your Bible, said there was no God with him. So if he said Jesus is God, that word in the beginning, if it is God, that is going against what God said in the book of Deuteronomy 32:39, there was no God with him. Furthermore, in the Bible, it is mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 45, verse number 6, God said that from the rising of the sun to the place of his setting, men may know there is none besides me, I'm the Lord and there is no other. Brothers and sisters, the Old Testament is the pretty verses where God speaks about his oneness, which goes against this concept of Trinity. Trinity is a fabrication. Furthermore, in the Bible again, God is talking here. I'm quoting a verse from the Old Testament where God speaks about his oneness and his uniqueness. In the Bible again, in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 40, verse number 25, says that, to whom will you compare me? Oh, who is my equal, says the Holy One. God is telling you, to whom will you compare me, or who is my equal? Furthermore, in the Bible, God is speaking. Furthermore, in the Bible, it is mentioned in the book of Isaiah again, chapter number 45, verse number 23. God said, by myself I have sworn, my mouth has uttered in all integrity a word that may be revoked. Before me every knee will bow, by me every tongue will swear. God said, before me every knee will bow. But now you are now bowing down to Jesus. You are going against what God said in the Old Testament. Because you are following Paul. Paul is the one who tells you to bow down to Jesus. In the book of Philippians, chapter number 2, verse number 10, Paul said that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. But God said you shall bow down to him alone, my brothers and sisters. Can I declare proof, my brothers and sisters, that Almighty God is the only one Lord? Go to the Old Testament before you start quote the New Testament, because God doesn't change his mind. He's only one Lord. Boromo in the Old Testament. It is mentioned in the book of Exodus, chapter number 20, verses number 3 to 5. God said here, you shall not bow down to anything in heaven, on earth, and on the earth. For he is a jealous God. You shall not have any God other God besides me. You shall not make for yourself a graven image or any likeness or anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them or serve them. For that I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God. In this verse again, in the book of Exodus 23 to 5, God is now here talking about his oneness, his uniqueness, that you should bow down to him alone, my brothers and sisters. Furthermore, in the Bible, in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 40, Isaiah chapter number 24, verse number 44. Isaiah 24, 44, God is speaking here, said, I'm the Lord who made all things, who alone stretched out the heavens, who spread the earth by myself. Now we are told that Jesus is a God, that he created everything. But in this verse, Jesus, Almighty God, is speaking that he alone created everything. Now, brothers and sisters, the Bible, as I said, is replete with verses in the Old Testament where God, Almighty God, speaks about his oneness and his uniqueness. So many verses, including in the book of Exodus, chapter number 8, verse number 10. In the first book of Kings, chapter number 8, verse number 20. In the book of Isaiah, chapter number 5. No, in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 45, verse number 5. In the first book of Chronicles, chapter number 17, verse number 20. In the book of Psalms, chapter number 89, verse number 6. In all these verses, the Bible is talking about the oneness of God, Almighty God, only one Lord. And in James 2:19, James said, the brother of Jesus, James 2:19, says in this verse that you believe that God is one, you do well. Even the devils believe and tremble. You believe that God is one, you do well. Even the devils believe and tremble. And your Bible, a few more verses again, if you read the Bible, you believe in your Bible, it's the word of God. In the 1 Timothy chapter number 2, verse number 5, it says here that, for there is one God, and there is one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. This means that Jesus is not God. Furthermore, in the 1 Corinthians chapter number 8, verse number 6 says that, for us there is but one God, which is the Father, from whom all things came and for whom we live. The Bible says only one Lord. Jesus himself says that Almighty God is only one Lord. In the Gospel of Mark, chapter number 12, verse number 29. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Moses in the Bible, Deuteronomy 6:4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. We are inviting you, my brother and sister, to religion of Islam. Quran is the last and final revelation, which was revealed to the last and final prophet Muhammad. We believe in Jesus. We believe in Jesus as the Messiah sent to the children of Israel. He never said he's God. He never said worship me. As I said, Jesus in the Bible makes this thing so between him and Almighty God. Several verses. I've been coming here for the past 4 years and I've quoted extensively from the Bible. Verses from the Bible why Jesus makes a distinction between him and Almighty God. So he cannot be God. For example, in the book of, in the Gospel of John, chapter number 8, verse number 32, Jesus said here, he said, Jesus said to them, if God were your Father, you would love me, for I have come here from God. I have not come out on my own. God sent me. Jesus said, God sent him. So how could Jesus be God? My brothers and sisters, Islam simply means submit your way to Almighty God. All the prophets were given only one message, which is the oneness of God, which is worship the only one Lord God and not associating any partners to him. And one word for that in Arabic, Islam, it means submit your way to Almighty God and not associating any partners with him. So Jesus Christ and all the prophets were Muslims. you are following the teachings of the church. Well, I said, the Bible, if you study it well, you find out that Almighty God is the only one Lord in the Old Testament. And God never changed his mind, because the Bible said God is not an author of confusion. If you read the Bible, it is mentioned in the 1 Corinthians chapter number 14, verse number 33, for God is not an author of confusion. And in the book of Psalms, chapter number 18, verse number 30, says that the way of the Lord is perfect. So if God in the Old Testament, or from beginning of time, says there's only one Lord, that him alone deserves to worship, then how come now you're telling me God changed his mind? In the beginning of time, he's only one Lord. Him alone deserves to be worshipped. And now you're telling me that God now is a triune God. It's a confusion. And the Bible said that God is not an author of confusion. My brothers and sisters, we invite you to religion of all the prophets, which is Islam. Every single person born today should follow the last and final messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Quran. If you read God's Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Ibrahim, chapter number 14, verse number 52, says that this Quran is a clear message for the whole of mankind. Let them take warning therefrom. Let them know that there is only one Allah, only one God, one Allah, and let the men of understanding take heed. For the God's Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 185, says that the Quran, that Ramadan was a month in which the Holy Quran was revealed as a guidance for mankind, and clear proof for the guidance and the criterion between right and wrong. For the God's Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Al-Kalam, chapter number 68, verse number 52. Surah Al-Kalam 68:52 says that وَمَا هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرُ لِلْعَالَمِينَ, but it is nothing else but a message to the Alameen. The Quran is nothing else but a message to the Alameen, to mankind and jinn and all that exists. Furthermore, you go to the Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter number 21, verses number 107, said that وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a mercy to Alameen, as a mercy to mankind, jinn and all that exists. For the God of Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Saba, chapter number 34, verse number 28, says that وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَصِيرًا وَنَصِيرًا وَلَكِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a universal messenger, giving glad tidings and warning them against the sin. But most of the human beings, they do not know. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last and final messenger sent to the whole of mankind. All the previous messengers who were sent before him were sent to their nations. But he is the only messenger, the last and final messenger sent to the whole of mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Azab, chapter number 33, verse number 40, says that Muhammad is not the father of any of you men, but he is the messenger of Allah and the seed of the prophets, the last and final prophet. Furthermore, if you read the hadith now, I'll go to the hadith now, what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about himself. If you go to the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, chapter number 56, hadith number 429, it says that all the previous messengers that came before me were sent to their people, to their nations, but I have been sent as a last and final messenger to the whole humanity. So my brothers and sisters, as I said, I'm going to end this video here with another verse in the Quran. If you read the God's Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Al-Araf, chapter number 7, verses number 158. Here in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding Prophet Muhammad to say to mankind. He said, say, O Muhammad, say to mankind, O mankind, indeed, I am the messenger of Allah sent to you all, to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. There is no deity except him. He gives life and causes death. So believe in Allah and his messenger, the unlettered prophet who believes in Allah and his words, and follow him that you may be guided, my brothers and sisters. So one more verse in the Bible. I'm going to end this video with one verse from the Bible. If you didn't go to the Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, says that, Qul ya ahlal kitab, say all people of the book, ta'alu ila kalimatin sawa'in bayna wa baynakum, that come to common terms as we do as a you. Allah na'budu illa Allah, that you worship none but Allah. Wala nusuk say abish, that we associate no partners with him. Wala yatakshu dhabatina ababa midunullah, that we erect not from among ourselves laws or patrons other than Allah, fa inta Allah. But if they turn away, fa kulu sadu, then bear witness, they are now Muslimun, then we are Muslims, bowing to Allah's will. My brothers and sisters, this end of the video here. As I said, we read the Quran, we are inviting you to religion of all the prophets, which is Islam. Don't take anyone's word for it. Get a copy of the Quran from the mosque or your Muslim neighbor or friends. Get a copy and then go at the back of the, check the index. Go for J, anything that says about Jesus, read it. Amma inshallah, we pray to Allah to guide you to the straight path, which is Islam. Bakra dawana, walhamdulillah, bi alamin.